So I'd like to welcome everyone today, the Trinity Sunday on May 30th. And I'd like to thank the worship leaders this morning, Tissa, Murphy, Susan, Sean, Doug, and Marilyn, who led the children's time at 9:30. I'd like to wish a happy birthday this week to Joshua, who was born on June 2nd in Japan. And we have a community speaker tomorrow night at 7, and Douglas, who is a well-known author and who has been a guest at the CBC. And you have to pre-register for speaker's request, and that is easy to do. And Doug has the link in this morning's e-news. The survey from the Spiritual Life are available for viewing, and you can also see the link in the e-news. And thank you very much to all who participated. The one suggestion that was made in the survey was to turn off the video to save on the bandwidth and to save on the, I guess, a little bit of electricity as well. So it is a greener option. And Emily has sent an announcement that she would like to make.
Good morning, everyone. As you probably know, Jane and I are teaming up to create a donation drive for the women at Juliet's Place. So continuing this initiative, there will be a church drop-off on Saturday, June 5th from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. So if you have any products like shampoo, conditioner, shower gels, dental products, lotion, sunscreen, laundry detergent, other toiletries, and feminine hygiene products, please come to the church on June 5th to drop off your items. You can also refer to the Women's Drive poster on the e-news for this information. Thank you so much for your continued support, and I look forward to seeing you there.
Well, I look forward to seeing you there too, Emily. Anyways, next Sunday, there will be communion, and it will be my last communion service with you. And please remember to bring bread and juice or any of the variations to worship next Sunday. And June 13th, we have a guest speaker, Dr. Carrie Crow, who will speak about creation, body, and spirituality. And for that Sunday, please bring a potted plant beside you for worship. There's a good food box pickup this Wednesday, and the church library is open if you like to borrow a book or drop off the books you have already read. And it is from 12 o'clock noon till 1:30. The orders for the grandmother's gift cards will be received from June 6th until June 13th. And please contact Bala to support the grandmothers in Africa who are looking after their orphaned grandchildren. And today I am wearing orange shirt in remembrance of the 215 children whose remains have been discovered in the former residential school in Kamloops, BC. It is a horrific reminder of Canadian history. We mourn the loss of young children, the pain in the families, and the devastation of Indigenous communities who continue to suffer. We pray for healing and reconciliation as we remember, pray, and walk with our Indigenous brothers and sisters. May God be with us in this journey of sorrow, pain, and healing hope. Let us take a moment of silence to remember, trusting that God is with us, and as we also prepare our hearts for worship. Please join Tissa and I as we lead the call to worship. From the distant galaxies to the invisible atom, from the highest of mountains to the depths of the sea, you, O God, created all.
Thank you, Creator God.
As a baby in a manger born, a curious teenager, a courageous prophet, a wise teacher, and faithful friend, you, O God, have saved us all.
Thank you, Redeeming God.
For the inspiration of the scriptures, the whisper of creativity, and the empowering of gifts.
Thank you for sustaining God.
In your unity, diversity, divinity, and mystery.
We praise you, O Triune God.
Come, let us worship.
Great living God, you have led us to this place to be transformed by your love. Open our hearts, souls, and minds through the power of your Spirit. May we live as the vehicle of your infinite Spirit so that we may grow in humility, gentleness, and compassion of Jesus the Christ, our Savior and our brother. Amen. Next hymn is Holy, 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 Voices United, 315.
Thank you very much, choir, for that lovely hymn and singing the descant. The psalm reading is the Psalm 29, and we'll be following along in Voices 756. And Tissa and I will read this together, and please join us And we will begin with the refrain.
Glory, glory, glory to our God.
Ascribe to God, you powers of the heaven, ascribe to God all glory and strength.
Ascribe due honor to God's holy name and worship in the beauty of holiness.
Glory, glory, glory to our God.
God's voice is over the waters, God's glory thundering across the great waters.
God's voice is power. God's voice is full of majesty.
God's voice shatters the cedars, splinters the cedars of Lebanon.
God's voice makes Lebanon skip like a calf, Mount Hermon stampede like a wild young bull.
God's voice forks into tongues of fire. God's voice shakes the wilderness, sets trembling the wilderness of Kadesh.
God's voice causes the oaks to whirl, stripping the forest bare, and the temple all cry, glory.
Glory, glory, glory to our God.
God sits enthroned above the waters.
God is enthroned as sovereign forever.
You give strength to your people, O God.
Now give to your people the blessing of peace.
Glory, glory, glory to our God.
The scripture reading this morning comes to us from Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 to 8. And this is the story of how Isaiah, God is calling as a prophet, and it happened in a worship setting before God. And Tissa and I will read this together.
In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had six wings. With two, they covered their faces, and with two, they covered their feet, and with two, they flew. And one called to another and said,
"Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory."
The pivots on the thresholds shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said,
"Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send and who will go for us?"
And I said, "Here am I. Send me."
When I was at Emmanuel College, every Wednesday afternoon, we had worship services, which gave us opportunities to hear gifted preachers, which included former moderators. I was deeply impressed with the very Reverend Lois Wilson, who many know is a very petite woman, but she spoke with such an authority that astounded me. Then there was the Reverend Cliff Elliott, who was known as a moderator who never became a moderator. I really appreciated his preaching style, his eloquence, and his choice of words and his energy. There was one thing he said, which I can never forget. In the 1970s, Reverend Elliott was the minister at the Metropolitan United Church in downtown Toronto, not too far from the Eaton Center. In the 1970s, people began to move out of downtown Toronto to the suburbs in vast numbers. The church membership and attendance declined so dramatically that the church considered closing its doors. It even grabbed the attention of the Toronto Star, who sent a reporter to interview the minister. One of the questions that the interviewer or the reporter asked was, what will people miss if the church closed its doors? Reverend Elliott thought about it for a minute. He thought a lot of what churches provide can be met by other means. If people like singing, then they can join a community choir. If they like to do charity work, then there are organizations for that too. If people enjoy being with one another, then the friendships can continue. If they like belonging, then there are clubs and bowling leagues. If they like the intellectual stimuli, then they can sign up for night classes at local colleges and universities. Reverend Elliott replied, if church were to close, then people will miss worship. People will miss the sacred experience of worship. To tell you the truth, even as a theology student and someone who grew up in church and has hardly ever missed a Sunday service, I did not understand fully what he had said at that time. It took a long time for me to come to the appreciation of what Reverend Elliott said about worship. When we moved to Japan as United Church overseas personnel, we began to worship in a Japanese congregation that was started by an American Methodist missionary some 120 years prior to our arrival. His wife started a Christian school for girls with six students, which eventually became a school of 1,000 students where we worked. Each Sunday, we attended church and we worshiped in Japanese. Thankfully, the school chaplain sat beside us and translated the sermon in English on his notepad. We learned the Japanese alphabet, and that enabled us to join in the singing. Many of the congregation members knew how to read music, and they sang beautifully, which was the highlight of the service each and every Sunday, along with a simple $2 lunch that the church provided after the service to encourage a fellowship time. Then one year, Joshua was born, and we decided to come back to Canada during the Christmas holidays and have Joshua baptized at Islington United Church by my roommate from Emmanuel College. As we began to worship in English this time, after a year of only hearing worship in Japanese, we began to appreciate the worship with the familiar structure of the call to worship, opening prayer, and singing a favorite hymn which we could understand. And the experience moved me, which I had never felt before at a worship service. Salty water started to flow out of my eyes. I turned and looked at Angie, and she was crying as well. It felt as though we were back in our spiritual home once again, and we were nourished. I realized then how much I missed United Church worship and what worship really meant to me. It was at that time that I truly understood what Reverend Elliot meant all those years ago. Isaiah had an incredibly profound experience when he was also at worship. He was at the temple in Jerusalem, which was supposed to have been God's dwelling place on earth. There he noticed God sitting on the throne, surrounded by seraphs, which are angelic beings of highest order. One angel said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." Isaiah was in the presence of God, and it reminded him that God is holy. At the same time, we human beings are different. Isaiah realized that he was spiritually unclean, that he lived amongst the people who did not speak the truth, nor did compassionate things to one another. He felt incredibly inadequate, as he said, "Woe is me." As Christians, we have the tendency to really denigrate ourselves, which can be unhealthy for our own self-esteem and psychological well-being. There are many Catholic jokes about all the guilt that they carry. For Isaiah, however, he makes a confessional statement in his holy encounter with God. I can resonate with what he might have felt when I think back to the time when I was up at Bruce Peninsula National Park, where I saw all the stars above me, where I saw the Milky Way galaxy even. I was standing before the sparkling stars above and the vastness of the universe that went even beyond my own imagination. I felt as though I was standing before God's greatness, and I felt humble. I did not say, "Woe is me," but I felt incredibly small, and that feeling of smallness also felt like worship to me. In our Christian worship service, we praise God. We get a chance to experience a sense of God's sacredness revealed to us by the good news of the scripture and through the visible sign of God's invisible grace in communion. When we encounter God, something in us gets changed. For Isaiah, he underwent a transformation that empowered him to work, to serve his community, and to bear witness to God's name. For him, his call was to be a prophet, to name the sins of his nation, which were political arrogance, spiritual pride, and economic injustice. The United Church also has been at the forefront of calling out the sins of our society that has favored economic growth while destroying the environment, that has ignored the plight of the weak and vulnerable, advocated for economic justice for the oppressed, and voiced opposition to senseless wars. Now, while acknowledging our part in the residential school, we are seeking healing and reconciliation with the indigenous peoples. We worship God and not idols. Worship service gives us the opportunity to praise God, who is the creator of the universe, to enter into a time of confession and forgiveness, to listen for the good news, and to respond to the word of God. What happens when we miss worship and not have this sacred experience? I imagine that our self-identity remains at the level of materiality. We can get tired of that very quickly. We may feel spiritually empty and restless. Nothing on earth can fill the sacred void, no matter how hard we try. God, however, gives us heavenly bread that satiates our deepest hunger and gives us a drink that quenches our deepest thirst through the word that he gives to us. Like Isaiah, God also calls us to live a life that we are meant to live, a life of meaning and purpose, and a life of humble service where others may see that God is truly working in us and through us in the power of the Holy Spirit. All we then need to say is, thank you for the opportunity to serve. Here I am. Send me. Thanks be to God. Our next hymn is I, the Lord of Sea and Sky, 509, in the Voices United. Thank you for your response to the call of God as you live your faith with authenticity, with your compassion, with your peace and generosity. And thank you for continuing to serve one another, to serve God with all your gifts and talents and your treasures. Gathering all our gratitude into one, let us pray the prayer of dedication together. God the Creator, Jesus our Redeemer, and Holy Spirit our Sustainer, you model for us what it means to be a community in your self-giving and sacrificial nature. As we bring our offerings before you, we pray that you would use them for your purposes, that your glory would be shown in every area of our world. Bless our gifts and bless us so that we can glorify your name as we serve your world. Amen. Let us come before God, who is the God of the universe, who is the source of life, the power of life, and the joy of life. Let us come with reverence and gratitude, offering our prayers and our silent longings into God's humble care. Let us pray. O God, who is the breath of our breath giving us life, and whose heartbeat echoes in the chambers of our heart, we give you thanks. The whole creation is bursting with your creativity, beauty, and vitality. We give you thanks and praise for the opportunity to participate in your life, where we live, move, and have our being through you. It is indeed a privilege and honor to live, to love, and to experience the full range of life, including sadness and joy, struggle and triumph, pain and relief, humor and delight. God of grace, hear our prayer. God who taught us to live in justice and kindness, we offer our sorrow at times when we have failed to live according to your ways. This morning, we remember the legacy of colonialism and the residential school for Aboriginal children. It is really hard to put into words how people suffered as individuals and as a community. Our words seem futile, but we know that your spirit breathes sighs too deep for our words. We pray that you are with us in the journey of reconciliation. May your spirit surround the Indigenous community and the soul of this nation so that we may be healed. God of grace, hear our prayer. O God, our Creator, Jesus, our Redeemer, and Holy Spirit, our Sustainer, we praise you. You are with us in a myriad of mysterious ways and in ways beyond our intellectual capacity. Yet we praise you for your goodness, for your presence in our souls and in our world. Help us not to forget that you are in us and me in you and others by the Spirit. God of grace, hear our prayer. O God, we continue to pray for this world as people continue to suffer under the pandemic. We pray for the families who have lost their loved ones and those who are suffering economically, physically, and spiritually in this crisis. We pray for students and teachers who find online learning and teaching to be incredibly challenging. We pray for nations who do not have the vaccine, who are facing new surges with new variants. God, may your compassion lead to greater sharing of resources and vaccines among the nations so that we may all be healed. God of grace, hear our prayer. O God of love, thank you for the gift of your community, which we call Ebenezer. The name reminds us that you are our helper, our strength, and our hope. Be with us as we go forward calling for a new minister. Be with the search team in their task. Bless the ad hoc committee as they discern how you would like them to steward the Shylock Fund for your glory and to further the mission and ministry of Jesus Christ. In their decision-making process, may your wisdom and your vision prevail. God of grace, hear our prayer. Healer of our every ill, light of each tomorrow, give us peace beyond our fear and hope beyond our sorrow. We pray for all those in need, whether in body, mind, or spirit, that your healing light and presence will bring comfort and peace. We pray for Roy Dixon, Michelle Gillette, Mavis Grange and her daughter, Dorothy Grant, Joan and Joyce's friends, David and Donna Lee, Phyllis Harvey, Minnick's mother Iris, Doug's sister Jackie, Tanya's friends Kristen, Barbara Nation, Rick Saunders, Diane's friend Tokiko, Joseph Salins, Joseph Stepania, Mary's brother Basil, Mary's friend Andrea, Peter Toison's daughter Veronica and her organ donor, Connie's friend Elaine Leba and her daughter Andrea, Linda Wilson's friend Linda and her family, Susan's friends Joy and Reg and their daughter Erin, Heather and Will, Sarah and Demetrios, Sarah's friend Terrence, Sarah's uncle Dave, Juan's spiritual director, Ignatius, Carrie Cole's niece, Rebecca, and all those we name in silence. God of grace, hear our prayer.
And in your love, answer.
Trusting in your overflowing grace and healing powers, trusting that your will be done, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hear the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
As we leave this place where we have encountered God's presence, let us go, cleansed by God's grace, empowered by God's call, and committed to being God's agents of grace and love, knowing that we do not work alone, for we do it in Christ's name and with power of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer. Amen. Let us go now in peace.
Go now in peace.
please join us next Sunday with communion, and children's time is at 9:30.